aquatic mammals like dolphins, like even beavers, like whales, they do not have gills. So they have to come up and breathe. So how come they can hold their breath so much longer than we humans? It is because they have a strongly developed mammalian diving reflex. We also have this, but we have to train it. The more we dive, the more we train for free diving, the more we hold up our breath, the more we train this mammalian diving reflex, and the more it will help us in holding our breath longer and diving deeper. So this mammalian diving reflex comes with four physiological adaptations, and the first one is bradycardia. So bradycardia is the lowering of the heartbeat. So as you hold your breath longer, your heartbeat will lower, and that is to conserve oxygen. So if you're using too much energy, then you're using too much oxygen, and that is oxygen that you want to use to hold your breath longer. So imagine your heart, which is a muscle, going fast, then you will use more oxygen. So your body and your mind automatically know, oh, this person here is holding his breath, so I gotta slow down now to make him help hold his breath longer. So that is bradycardia. So there have been done tests. Some say that the lowest that has ever been measured was like 20 beats per minute or even lower. Other experiments say something more like 30 beats per minute. And all those measurements were done for dives at 100 meters deep. So that is like extreme advanced divers. For most of the mortal human beings, when we hold our breath, and let's say you start from a resting heartbeat of 60 beats per minute. If you can lower it down to 50, to 45 or 40, then that's already a nice thing to see. And then you can see and understand that breath holding is not about how long can I hold my breath, but it is about triggering those physiological adaptations in your body, like bradycardia, so you can relax, so you can slow down, literally slow down. And just have a moment for yourself, for your brain and your body to slow down and get away from the hectic, stressed world, and just have a moment for yourself. So breath holding is a meditation, actually. Another physiological adaptation is vasoconstriction. So vasoconstriction is the narrowing of the blood vessels in the extremities of your body, like your fingers, also your hands, your toes, your feet. So when the blood vessels here narrow, then the blood flow will be restricted. So that blood we need for our vital organs, like the lungs, the heart, and especially the brain. So as we hold our breath longer and we dive deeper, we want to make sure that we, well, do not black out. So I don't want to sound too dramatic, but if you hold your breath too long, then you can lose consciousness. So to prevent this, our body knows what to do. So vasoconstriction is one of those physiological adaptations. Basically, our body is saying, hey, we do not need extra blood flow in the fingers and the toes now. We need that blood flow for the vital organs so that the whole organism can keep on functioning. A third physiological adaptation is called the blood shift. Now, I need a little more explanation on this one, because the blood shift is extremely important in free diving and in deeper free diving. So as you dive deeper, what happens? So when you take your final breath on the surface, we take in air that is at atmospheric pressure. That is 1 bar. That is the pressure here, air. The pressure that we experience on a daily basis. This is 1 bar. But as you dive deeper, there's going to be more pressure from the water. So at 10 meters, we already have 2 bar, and 2 bar is double of 1 bar. So that means twice the pressure at 10 meters deep than you would have on the surface. So what happens with our lungs? Because our lungs are compressible, the air is compressible. So at 10 meters depth, we have lungs that are already 50% of the original volume. If we dive deeper at 20 meters, we have 3 bar. If we dive deeper at 30 meters, we have 4 bar, which is 4 times the pressure of the surface. This means that our lungs will be 25% only of the original volume. Now, if you would keep on deeper, diving deeper, there would be more pressure from the water. So you would think, okay, these lungs are going to shrink and shrink and shrink. Eventually, I mean, this cannot happen, because eventually they will be so small that the structures of the lungs itself would get damaged. So this doesn't happen. So your body knows that, from, oh, we are diving deeper here. This is actually deeper than residual volume. This is already a bit advanced, but residual volume is basically the volume of air in your lungs when your lungs cannot get compressed anymore, so when they cannot get any smaller anymore. And that usually happens between 30 and 40 meters of depth. So you have to be already a bit an advanced freediver to get there. So starting from that depth, the blood shift really kicks in to prevent the lungs from shrinking anymore. So blood shift is basically the blood vessels that are around your lungs, around the alveoli. So when extra blood flow goes to these blood vessels that are around the alveoli of your lungs, you could look at it as a cushion of blood. Your body forms like a cushion of blood around your lungs to protect those lungs from basically imploding, so from basically getting any smaller. And that is why freedivers can dive deeper than residual volume. They can dive deeper than 40 meters. I mean, the world record with a monofin is 130 meters by Alexey Moshanov. And freedivers have gone even deeper on more, I would say, less modern freediving disciplines like variable weight and No Limits. If you've seen the movie The Big Blue, it's a cult movie. Everyone has to see this. I think this movie is older than 30 years or maybe 35 years already. So they go down on a sledge, and that is an ancient form. It's still practiced, but more and more in modern freediving, we let this thing apart and we just use our own force, like using fins or monofins. So just to say that in the No Limits discipline, people have gone way deeper than 130 meters. So this is all because of the blood shift. So the more trained you are as a freediver, the more strong this blood shift will kick in. And then a fourth physiological adaptation that happens during this part of the mammalian diving reflex is the spleen contraction. Now the spleen contraction is an organ, if I'm not mistaken, on the left side of your body. So when you dive and you hold your breath, this spleen contracts, and the spleen consists of holds a lot of oxygen-rich red blood cells. So oxygen in our bloodstream is transported through our bloodstream. So the red blood cells, they carry oxygen. It's actually the hemoglobin in the red blood cells. So the hemoglobin, or a red protein in the red blood cells, that carry the oxygen throughout our body and release it to our tissues so we can use it. So the spleen contraction, when we dive deeper, when we hold our breath longer, contracts and releases these oxygen-rich red blood cells so we can hold our breath even longer. So basically, rounding up the mammalian diving reflex, these are all physiological adaptations that our body automatically will trigger just to help us holding our breath longer and dive deeper. And this is just so amazing about freediving. And when you learn to deal with these sensations and you learn how to trigger them and you learn how to train for them so they become stronger, that's when you become a more advanced freediver.